What if I were to tell you there's an organization that's been around in one form or another since men have been fighting? Every time there's an act of civil disobedience that's committed for the greater good, there we are. Open your eyes. Even if you can't always see it, you can smell it. It's in the air. It's on the evening news. Change is coming. Change is happening, and the Order is recruiting again. That's the realm of our journeyman, Master Crudelli. He scours the world's deepest corners, looking for fighters. He tests them. You either have it or you don't. Sometimes they send back nothing. Sometimes they send back gold. We're looking for tomorrow's leaders.
I've been doing this job for so long now that the job is my recreation. There's no distinction between my time and the Order's time. A friend of mine, I talked to him in depth about my instructions to have a film crew follow me around, and he was like, no, do not do that. You have just become a target.
So who's these guys here?
They're filming me. We're making a little documentary.
If I could change something about this, I wouldn't have the crew. I'm bloody unhappy about exposing what we're doing. We're sticking out like a sore thumb. We're getting a lot of unwanted attention. The reasons have been explained to me why we have to do it this way. Stuff is leaking on the internet. We're trying to give a positive face to the organisation. But I can tell you, you're not seeing the whole picture. There are parts of what we do as an organisation that you will never see. People say that the Zulus, they either like you or they hate you. So as an organisation, we need to bear that in mind and stay on the right side of these people. They're a brave warrior culture with very proud traditions. And I think that is very, very useful for what we're trying to achieve here.
Hello.
Sabona.
Thank you.
Amsini, he's one of our talent scouts. He's a teacher. He knows what we do. He believes in what we do.
Yeah, Mr. Amsini?
Yes.
Chris.
Fighters.
Fighters.
Oh, let's go.
Okay. These are your boys?
Yeah, these are my boys.
How long have they been with you for, these guys?
They've been training since they were just 5 years.
Let's get four guys, get them to do a little bit of fighting and see what they've got, yeah?
Mavio.
Big one looks good. What's the personality like?
Assign him a duty. He's gonna do that duty very, very perfectly.
Okay, you can stop him.
Okay, whoa!
Okay, good. Let's get the other two. Let's have a look at those, yeah. You're good fighters. You know what you came here for.
That's right, yeah?
But the journey is not going to be easy. A warrior needs to like to fight, but he also needs to learn new things. It's your choice.
I'm going to go to the hospital.
kuti uyimisela uyimisela nje bangabe sambile sinezizwe ezinye nje siyazi tinda tinda yebo mfunde induku yakwelinye izwe neyakwelinye izwe ngingisuka nayo la.
Maviyo, says the one, Watola into Mazania, what in Rashala Nai.
Matanda for the Uguas, then when I buy ends, Namabang a palm, big one.
Namanga to his uncle. Nobody, eh, wait, I can't eat.
Lana nje lendawo into enza ukuthi ngize ngithande ngikhule ngilusela khona nokulwa futhi ngikhule futhi ngilwa khona nje ngizo lezi ndawo zonke lezi ngiqhatha babe ngiqhatha bebehlala kuyo la matshe lawa ngaze futhi ukuthi ngihluleke.
Amsini, he's the guy that plugs us into the culture here. Without him, it would be very difficult for me to operate.
We need to see Isangoma. This is going to help you to choose or to select the best stick fighter. Isangoma is very, very important in communicating everyone with his or her ancestors.
I understand that.
Yeah.
I don't really believe in it.
Even your ancestors, Isangoma knows about them before you even came here. Do you believe in that?
I don't really.
Magicians, fortune tellers, a lot of what they do is in the realms of psychology. The Sangomas here, I think they really act as very wise psychologists. They perform that kind of function.
I want to know about the people around me,
okay.
The people I work with.
Okay.
Are they sending me on a good journey or the wrong journey?
It was a pillar night, it was good to we are local goose. Benza Pelana Bem Ninga Bam Ninga Bancha Naba Ninga. Or Pelagon Lutok Sakers in Lucky's in Tangina.
So she's saying that I took some poison when I was young.
Yes, still young.
That is true. I did.
You did?
I did. How does she know that?
But why I got what told up, walking in my uncle and I got in luck with you. Conquer is a quasi nice in your way.
I'll do it here in Africa.
I don't consider myself a spiritual man. I'm not really one to lecture others on rights and wrongs, especially given my job because it's such a grey area. I was shocked with what that lady said to me. I did actually accidentally eat poison when I was a very young child. I don't think it's in my blood now, but I think that's her way of explaining something to me. Each country and each continent, I'm looking for something different. We can't be as rigid as we can back home when we're recruiting. When we're out in the field, there are a couple of key things that I'm looking for. I'm looking for somebody who has the motivation, first of all, to succeed, because the next phase of training is going to get even tougher. I'm looking for somebody who can rise to the challenge.
Okay, let's see what we got.
Organization are going to try and build leaders for the future, then the smaller fellow doesn't have the stature and he hasn't got the stamina. The other fella, he's still got time to learn, we can still mold him.
Stop. Good. We've seen a lot of action, courage, speed, all the things we need. I'm gonna see you tomorrow, okay? Good job.
Hi-yah.
Placebo effect is very powerful, and the more you believe in it, the more powerful the placebo effect is. Doesn't mean the medicine's rubbish. The yin yang is the medicine men. It's a very important function that they fulfill in the region. Hello?
Sabon.
Sabon.
Nejani.
Yeah, good, thank you. One of my fighters needs help. He will be a great man, but he needs to be protected from other people.
Okay.
So we come to get Muti.
Yeah, sizomenza.
They talk of the power of intention here. The intention of the medicine man who spent his whole life talking to the plants, putting his own energy into these things. Well, as a skeptic, there's still something that feels very tangible here and very real. We want something that will just protect the candidate, medicine of good nature, and good value, that will make any bad spells just bounce back.
What is that?
The Inyanga also gave me some medicine. I thought, yeah, I'll try that. And I gave it a go. I felt like I'd had 10 espressos, like this jolt came through me. I don't know what that was.
I feel a little bit strange now. Mm. You know, I feel like a little bit, like, weird.
Okay.
Is that what it's supposed to do? My vision feels very clear. It's some kind of drug, yeah?
Yeah.
Is it herbal magic? I can't speak. What the hell is it doing to me?
I was like, what? What's happening to me? Is it a psychological effect? Because the whole environment creates this kind of energy and this belief. But still, yeah. We work with that, and we still get what we want.
Put it here and here, yeah?
Yeah.
Make his arms strong.
Even the lightning cannot.
Okay. Thank you.
Oh, thank you very much.
And I have enjoyed eating your magic.
Thank you. Yeah, bom.
The Sangoma, she said, in order to help me get the poison out of my own blood, that I needed to sacrifice a goat. And that is why I decided to build that challenge into what we're doing here. Kill two birds with one stone.
I have something for you. This Muti, when you rub it on your arms, you will be able to defend and hit hard. If you accept Muti, you are going to become an important man. Please think carefully if you want to take the Muti or not.
I'm not sure whether I necessarily believe in those potions, you know, chemically, but when you put the intention onto these things, as they do, and you pass that on, you could see this guy, he was scared, he was nervous, he didn't know whether he should take the Muti, and he rose to the challenge, and that's what I'm looking for.
You taste it.
You take it?
Good.
When he accepted his Muti, I wanted to really test him, and I wanted him to do something that would be completely alien to him.
Here is another tribe, another village.
uthi sizohamba nawe siye lapho siyotshontsha imbuzi.
My Sangoma said I should sacrifice a goat for my ancestors. What happened? They'll shoot you.
We're making him cross his boundaries and we're making him show his commitment to the organisation. Now, if he can do that, he's got the right stuff.
We will see your courage.
I'll come with you. And so we'll get shot together.
I'm not happy about having a production crew, bunch of Muppets following you with big cameras shouting this, that and the other. And it's also adding an element of risk, not only to myself, but also the potential candidate.
I can't proceed while they're there.
Bush justice takes place here on a daily basis. They don't ask you questions and sit you down with handcuffs on. They see you doing something wrong or they hear you've done something wrong, they'll execute you on the spot. So for him to steal a goat, it's an impossible wall, it's an impossible barrier to break.
We don't have long to make this happen.
Told by the Sangoma to kill the goat and take the bile to please the ancestors.
Yeah. Okay, eat.
Recruiting the right man for this job, given the fact that we're coming from vastly, vastly different cultures, has had its challenges. I've had to communicate with this guy in his own language to a degree. I've had to speak in terms of magic, in terms of power, the sorts of things that he understands.
You did a good job today. Enjoy the food. Yes? I will see you tomorrow. Okay? Yeah? Today, we will see if you can learn.
Push! Push! Why?
Legs. Strong.
Strong.
Good.
Push. Stop me. Stop me.
I love this, yes.
All day. Happy.
One, two, Yabula five, Yabula six, Yabula nine.
I forgot the next number.
Yabula 10. Good.
What happens if you drop your shield? You have to block your stick. We have to do this to make your arms strong. 10. Forget about pain. It's 10 or it's nothing.
10.
20? I told you it would be tough, but if you want to learn from me, I will teach you. 9, 10. Good, yeah.
Oh,
this foot steps behind here. Push the neck, yeah? Okay, you try.
Good,
yeah?
Good,
okay. Smoother. 1, 2. good, yeah?
The recruiting process is the most difficult thing. We have certain ideals, and I think that's important when we're building leaders within our organisation to make sure that he's one of the best that they've got, without a doubt. Ended up choosing, he's got the right stuff. It was a challenge for him, but his desire to join our organisation is greater than his fear.
You have done very well, and I would like to accept you as our student. When the time is right, we will meet again.
Obviously, chaos has its own natural order, but above that is the order. We need to make sure that we respect that by keeping quiet about it. So if you think what you're seeing is the whole picture, you can think again. From our point of view, what's important is that I'm making a leader, because we can't be everywhere at once.